Yes. Well, it's going to cause costs to go up. The price may not. The tax is going to be what generates the increase. And prices may follow as people, as businesses seek to recoup or pass it on. But that's going to decrease the activity.
If it does not decrease the activity and they just keep producing as usual, they will.
Well, then there's no reason for this, because these guys are saying, this is a concession to Al Gore. These guys are saying that one of the good things about this energy tax is it's going to cause us to be more conservative in our usage of fuels.
But when is less production ever better? That sounds totally anti-capitalistic.
You're absolutely right.
And also, Rush, I was going to recommend some reading for the...
I want to go back to what you said about interest rates. Finish? No. I want you to finish this theory.
Okay.
So now we left off. Energy costs cause prices to go up, which cause inflation to go up. Then what?
Inflation goes up, then the cost of money, it costs more for you to tie up your money over time, so interest rates have to follow.
Right. Now, here is why the activity is going to decrease. Don't forget something. You're making a slight miscalculation that many in the media are making. The Clinton people are relying, they love these falling interest rates. They think this is the greatest thing in the world because this is going to spur the financing of purchases. Money costs less when the interest rates are down, and so people are going to go buy money. They're going to go put money to use. And in the short term, this is going to cause 93 to boom, because this will result. Look at what's happening. People are running out there to refinance their mortgages now. People are thinking of investing in long-term items because they got a low interest rate. The bond market, the people who are in charge of these interest rates, are figuring that these interest rates are going to fall even lower. They love this. Now, why do they think that? And where is your miscalculation? Your miscalculation is that as energy costs go up, you don't think that the activity, that activities that use energy is going to change. But it's going to have to, because if Bill Clinton, this is not an if, when he gets this tax package through, whatever gain people realize because of lower interest rates is going to be more than wiped out with these tax increases. People are going to have a net less amount of disposable income to spend, and so economic activity is by nature. There is no choice here but then for the economy to slow down. And when the economy slows down, the production slows down, every purchasing slows down, the whole cycle slows down, and you don't have inflation. You're heading toward either slow growth or maybe a recession. And in fact, many feel that if this goes too far, you're going to have deflation, not inflation. And it's because you forgot to factor in with your theory these massive tax increases, including the energy taxes that are going to just take disposable income away from people. And that's going to hit in 94. That's why 93 is going to be a boom year. Smart money is going to be buying things like crazy this year. This is the last year that you and I will own our own money. Next year, more and more of it's Bill Clinton's.
Well, Rush, I just urge people that are listening to you to read things like Atlas Shrugged or The Fountainhead, which are books about the dangers of liberals taking over and just having a totally socialistic environment. So let's all be on the awake for this.
Rebecca, thanks for calling.
Thank you, Rush.
I want to say something else about this energy tax, folks. All of this, not just the energy tax, but the energy tax, I think, more than most, is really an assault on our freedom. I have a phrase I love to say: when this BTU tax is enacted, you people will find out why we fought the Gulf War. It was for the free flow of BTUs at market prices. You will find out how crucial to economic strength, economic productivity, economic growth, a market-based, affordable energy price is. Be it for gasoline or any oil derivative or natural gas or whatever. When the price of energy is impacted dramatically upward, as was the case with the contrived so-called oil shortages of the early and mid-70s, even the late 70s they had one, you have all kinds of industry suffer, the leisure time industry mainly, theme parks, roadside motels and restaurants, because there's less people, fewer people driving for recreational purposes because it takes so much more money to buy the energy. And when this tax, and therefore your freedom is impacted, your freedom to move, your freedom to spend leisure dollars, your freedom to entertain yourself, your freedom to keep your house comfortable, all of these things. And it all, this is supposedly going to be good. This is a sacrifice. We must all experience short-term pain so that we can all have long-term pain. That's what this administration's about. We're going to have short-term pain so that we can all have long-term pain. And it's a, I think there's another story today in the Washington Post, this time a column by the economist Robert Samuelson. Half of the column praises Clinton's effort and praises his intention, which is wrong. The other half says it isn't going to work. It doesn't add up. The numbers that he has given us that are going to result from budget cuts and tax increases don't add up to anything good. So the shine is off. The plan does not work. The plan will not work. You people who think that patriotism is defined as supporting a liberal Democrat president with anything he wants to do, had better wake up. Why support it if it doesn't work? What's the point of that? Well, I'm going to be a good American. I'm going to support my president. Why, if he's wrong? If it's going to harm you, and if it's going to harm the country, well, it may harm the country, but if it's going to harm everybody, then it's okay. No! Why do we do that? It will not work. So what? Patriotism got to include some intelligence in it. Where in the definition of patriotism to say, I will stupidly follow my liberal Democrat president with anything he wants to do? Especially when patriotism is, there's another side of patriotism too. It's opposing a conservative Republican president. You know, where were you people when Reagan and Bush were in office? I will support my president regardless what, it didn't exist, did it? Now you got a liberal Democrat in there and you want to support it. The plan doesn't work and more people who are by nature the president's allies are slowly but surely whispering, hey, I don't think this is going to work. The Broder column yesterday was a whisper. It isn't going to work. I don't want to say it too loud, but it isn't going to work. And this is going to create a little hubbub, a buzz. It isn't going to work. Now, on my show, we've been shouting since September and October, it isn't going to work! Listen to us! It isn't going to work! The guy's not telling the truth. How do you know anyway what he's saying? The media ignored all of that. Media knew everything I knew. Everybody knew everything I knew. Everybody could look at Clinton and hear Clinton and see Clinton and know what Clinton was and wasn't. And now those who were silent during the campaign are starting to say, it isn't going to work. It ain't going to work. And pretty soon, we're going to hear, it isn't going to work. In plain English, from their side. We'll be back. So don't think patriotism means supporting folly. Back in just
You're listening to the EIB Network.
Everywhere I go, people are constantly offering me Snapple. Rush, have a Snapple. Here, have a Snapple. I was in San Francisco, of course, not long ago, and they had Snapple, made a special trip to go out and get Snapple for me because they know I am so closely tied to Snapple. Snapple is indeed the official beverage of the Excellence in Broadcasting Network. A bunch of different flavors of Snapple, and the product line's expanding all the time. Little company in the Northeast that in the past 3 years has rolled out nationally and has taken over the beverage market. Snapple is all natural. It's made from the best stuff on earth. And if you're tired of colas, and if you're tired of lemon and lime, and if you would like iced tea in a bunch of great flavors like raspberry or mint or lemon flavored, both sweetened and unsweetened, or with NutraSweet, it's available. And this stuff is so good. It is so popular that the major beverage manufacturers are coming out with competing brands, but don't buy them. Buy Snapple, made from the best stuff on earth.
You know, that motel that says it'll leave the light on for you ought to leave its phone off the hook. Because when you call them for reservations, the call alone can cost you several dollars. But call 1-800-843-5644 and a clean, comfortable room at nearly 200 Knights Inns, Knights Courts, Knight Stops, and Arbor Gate Inns can be waiting for you at true budget rates with no reservation charge at all. At Knights Lodging, we leave the lights off till you get here and give you the money we saved when you arrived.
Everybody gets hungry when they hear that name, Sandpiper Seafood.
Everybody knows that it's the place to go. You'll see your cousin Sally and your Uncle Joe. Their food is so delicious it'll make you say, if I had three wishes I'd be back today. Yeah, everybody knows that it's the place to go.
By now, everybody knows about Sandpiper Seafood, but not everybody knows why they're so famous. Well, here's just a few reasons. Maybe it's their hearty fish, their tasty shrimp, their succulent oysters, or their fresh coleslaw. Now, doesn't that make your mouth water? Well, now you know why everybody eats at Sandpiper Seafood.
You'll leave us feeling satisfied and wearing a grin, and knowing very soon that you'll be back again. Yeah, everybody knows that it's the place to go.
Sandpiper Seafood on Highway 70 in LaGrange. The place to go.
As you might have noticed, there are people who just seem to approach life with a little more confidence than others. They seem to be rather self-assured, in control. And it's not because they were born possessing all the wisdom of the ages. They simply know what they're doing when it comes to money. They know how to use credit and how not to. How to run their lives instead of life running them. Fortunately for the rest of us, however, Wachovia has now made it easier to achieve this enviable state. It's called Equity Bank Line, and it's a personal line of credit exclusively for homeowners. Unlike other ways to borrow, the interest you pay may be tax deductible, and it's as easy to use as writing a check. Call and ask a Wachovia personal banker for complete details about Equity Bank Line. It's the intelligent way to control your credit. Welcome to personal banking. Welcome to Wachovia.
Consult your tax advisor for details. Equal opportunity lender.
Now, more broadcast excellence on 1150 WGBR.
Rush Limbaugh, Doctor of Trichinology. As dubbed by the now famous Rita from Detroit. We haven't heard from her in a long time. God, I wonder what happened to Rita from Detroit. As you know, ladies and gentlemen, she's engaged to Minister Farrakhan, who has a spaceship circling the Earth where at any moment in time, he can beam up black people and keep orbiting the planet. And then at the appropriate time, all these black people will be beamed down to a country that is theirs. So said Rita, and she accused me of trichinology. And trichinology, actually not the words, we then learned that trichology was a Malcolm X term. She just added a syllable that wasn't there. And I got a letter here today from somebody, hey Rush, mega dittos to the doctor of talkology. The doctor of talkology metaphysics. My name is Tommy Dressler. I don't know where Tommy's from. That's another thing, you people writing letters on Computer, please put down what part of the country in which you reside. Back to the phones. It's 800-282-2882. Lucille in Los Gatos, California. Hi.
Hi, Rush. It's a pleasure talking with
you. Thank you very much. I'm glad to hear from you.
I enjoyed your book very much. And the Rush Limbaugh, your letter is great.
Thanks. Thank
now,
you.
I'm a little nervous for what I wanted to tell you. It's a little bit of a joke. In the town of Los Gatos, we couldn't figure out why Bill Clinton would come to our little town. And then in the newspaper yesterday, it mentioned that it listed the presidents that have come to Los Gatos, Clinton being the sixth president. And then in 1919, President Franklin Roosevelt, but at the time he was the Undersecretary of the Navy and was a guest of the United States Senator James Phelan. And after hearing that Mrs. Clinton has talks and listens to Eleanor Roosevelt,
mm-hmm.
we came to the conclusion that it made sense. Evidently, Eleanor told Hillary that they should go to Los Gatos and have a wonderful time, because evidently she enjoyed herself back in 1919. I mean, it all fell into place. It made great sense. And as always, we learned this from your TV show and from your radio show, which is extremely educational.
Yeah, we had a picture of Eleanor Roosevelt in our TV show. The crew did. I didn't even know they were going to do this.
That was wonderful.
They found a ghost version that is swept across the screen. I felt like Mrs. Gulch from The Wizard of Oz was on the show. Sweeping across my set. You know, that's interesting. Six presidents have ventured to Los Gatos?
Right. Yes.
Which ones are they?
Let's see. They listed them as William Harrison, Teddy Roosevelt, FDR, which at the time he wasn't president, Hubert Hoover, Richard Nixon, future late 1940.
Right.
I don't think he was the president at the time. I think he came campaigning for his congressional seat. And then William Jefferson Clinton, 1993.
Really? Okay, it's not what I thought. Some of those guys were not president when they were there.
No.
And obviously most of those guys were there when Los Gatos was not part of what is now known as Silicon Valley.
Oh, definitely not.
No.
Silicon Valley is relatively new, but we have a lot
of... There has to be some other conspiratorial reason why six presidents have been to Los Gatos. I wonder what it is.
Well, it's always been a mecca for Democrats. It's always been that. So perhaps, you know, there's just a pull. But I just thought it was interesting because now we know why he chose the town of Los Gatos, thanks to Mrs. Clinton.
Hey, you know, there's a bit. Do you have the Hillary update theme handy? Thanks for the call, Lucille. This is our first lady, wife of the president, Mrs. Bill Clinton update. Theme song from Alden Oaks.
Oh, here she comes. Watch out for her, she'll chew you up. Oh, here she comes. She's a man eater. Oh, here she comes. Watch out for her, she'll chew you up. Oh, here she comes. She's a man eater.
Okay, so the Los Angeles Times reported yesterday that the White House Health Care Task Force, headed by the president's wife, the First Lady, Mrs. Bill Clinton, has abandoned a proposal to tax health benefits that workers receive from employers. Now, this has long been a key element of the Clinton tax plan. And that's another thing. I want to tell you people something. This economic plan of President Clinton's is nothing other than a tax plan. Don't call it an economic plan. It's a tax plan. The more I think about this and the contradictions that are in it, the more outraged I become. On the one hand, here is the President of the United States talking about how you have worked harder for less all through the 80s, and he's going to fix that. So what's he going to do? He's going to take it from you this time. The rich took it from you in the 80s, and that's a bunch of fraud, lies, BS, too. The rich didn't take it from anybody. Rich took it from you in the 80s. This time, he's going to take it from you. Whatever, you're not going to have more. You're going to have less. And he sits there and says, you were hurt in the 80s because you had less. You worked harder. What's going to happen now is you're not going to work as hard, but you'll still have less. That's the underlying result of all this. It's not an economic plan. It's a tax plan that won't work. No tax increases ever reduce the deficit. I keep going back to the basics on this. You want to reduce the deficit. If that's your goal, cut spending and grow the economy and let people have more money to spend. That'll cause growth. Deficit was coming down, 87, 88, 89. Economic growth brought it down, not tax increases. A tax cut, by the way, 86 tax reform. Anyway, L.A. Times reports yesterday, we're not going to tax health care. Hillary Clinton's decided we're not going to tax health care benefits. Today, the White House has put out a correction. L.A. Times story was wrong. The White House disputes that report. The press secretary, Dee Dee Myers, do we know if she knows the truth on this announcement or not, says there have not been any final decisions on this issue. The task force chaired by the wife of the president, the first lady, Mrs. Bill Clinton, is looking at a number of options. So as it continues, still don't know what to believe from day to day with this administration.
The Kaufman Fund has been rated the number one performing mutual fund for the past 5 years by the Wall Street Journal. The Kaufman Fund, an aggressive growth fund dedicated to capital appreciation through investment in small growth companies. The Kaufman Fund has outperformed all other mutual funds with more than twice the average total return. Call for the free prospectus, 1-800-321-9042. Past performance is not necessarily indicative of future results, but for the past 5 years, Kaufman Fund has been number one in growth. 1-800-321-9042.
This is WGBR News, Goldsboro's very own.
Good afternoon. At 1:30, it's 42 degrees. I'm Dory Roberts. 15 Northeast Elementary School students who licked or tasted air freshener crystals brought to school by another student were given activated charcoal at Wayne Memorial Hospital yesterday afternoon to drink to absorb the substance. An official said the crystals appeared to be candy and were shared with classmates in the fourth and fifth grades. Several children began to complain after lunch and were taken to the hospital by rescue. They said their legs hurt and their stomachs were beginning to hurt and they didn't feel well. Teachers then learned those students had tasted the substance the other student brought to school. A school spokesperson said the crystals looked similar to rock crystal candy and that some students just tasted the crystals and decided they didn't like them, while others ate some. None of the students were seriously ill at any time. They did remain in the hospital a while for observation. A free retirement conference for state employees to be held in Wayne Center in Goldsboro on Thursday next week is among 19 such conferences being held across the state. The conferences are being held for employees planning to retire, personnel officers, retirement counselors, and persons advising on retirement matters. Officials say employees who deal with retirement matters and members who are 60 years or older, who are eligible to retire, will find these conferences to be beneficial. The conferences will provide complete information as to procedures in the retirement process, eligibility for retirement, calculation of benefits, the selection of optional payment arrangements, the designation of beneficiaries, the completion of forms, eligibility requirements for Social Security benefits, and other benefits available to employees. All conferences begin at 1:30 p.m., the day scheduled. Time now for a look at our forecast from the Weather Center. It's coming up right after this.
I'm proud to introduce your salesperson of the month, Dave Reichert.
The Home Entertainment Center at Sears carries a great variety of equipment for your selection. The Brand Central idea gives you famous brand names at Sears low prices. This is Dave Reichert, waiting to see you.
Sears, Berkeley Mall, Goldsboro.
You can count on me, Sears, Roebuck and Company.
Well, there's a snow advisory and a winter weather advisory in effect for most of the region for later this afternoon and tonight into early in the day on Friday. Probably not going to see much in the way of precipitation, though, this afternoon. The sunshine will be fading behind increasing clouds. It could start to snow in the extreme western part of the region out near Siler City, Southern Pines, and Roxboro toward dark. Highs 36 to 42. Snow will overspread the entire region this evening. Now, we'll start to see a change over to sleet and rain in the southern part of the region this evening, and eventually we'll see a changeover further north, even at Raleigh and Durham and Rocky Mountain, Lewisburg, although it could be all snow in the extreme north at Roxboro, Henderson, and Roanoke Rapids throughout the storm. Tonight's low 30 to 34, and all that precipitation will be tapering off by midday tomorrow. In terms of accumulations, we expect 2 to 4 inches north of Raleigh, Wilson, and Williamston. Further south, accumulation should be about 1 to 2 inches before that changeover takes place. I'm Brian Orzel in the Weather Center.
Thanks, Brian. It's 43 degrees now as we return return to Rush on WGBR.
The prestigious Attila the Hun chair of the famous Limbaugh Institute for Advanced Conservative Studies. Our number is 800-282-2882. My friends, during that most recent break, I made an executive programming decision. What we want to do, we want to go back in time. We want to turn back the hands of time. Who sang that song? Was that Tyrone Davis? 1968. Turn back the hands of time. Is that Tyrone Davis? It's Tyrone Davis. It's, yeah, 67. It's on the Hot Soul label. So I remember that play. I was back in the old days. Was it Brunswick? Decca, that's what it was. It was a gray label. I know that because I was a DJ back in those days. I actually played the old 45. Slip-cued them and all. Oh, man, what a day. Anyway, we sit here a lot, ladies and gentlemen, say, hey, I told you back then. Hey, we told you back then. Hey, you know, we said then, we so. There comes a time when one must document what one claims one said and did. We attempt to get the point home in many ways on this show. One of the things that we profoundly believe here is that humor happens to be one of the greatest lubricants there is when we are trying to persuade people to come here with our fists made and our teeth clenched each and every day and say, listen to us. We'll not get it done. We try to do it with humor in so many different ways. On occasion, we're serious. On occasion, we're frivolous. Sometimes we're humor. But our humor is always done with a clear point. So what I have asked our staff to do, and they've done, are we ready on this? We have assembled, ladies and gentlemen, not all, but most of the production bits that we have done over the course of the last 6 months on this tax business. If we wanted to, we could go to all the debates, we could get what Bush and Quayle said was going to happen with taxes. If you voted for Clinton, we could go get Clinton saying, it's pathetic to see the President of the United States lying this way. It's pathetic and sad to see Mr. Bush sink to this level. When all Mr. Bush was doing and all Mr. Quayle was doing was telling you the truth about who was going to be taxed in order to pay for what Mr. Clinton wanted to do. So I thought that we would play for you a series of our production bits from the past months. Some of these predate the elections. Many of them predate the inauguration. They're all accurate. They are all precisely hit the nail on the head. Let's just roll with them in order.
We only want to help you.
What? Congress cuts cable TV costs and my bill goes up?
We only want to help you.
And the good news is Congress got us free medical. The bad news, it cost me my job.
We only want to help you.
Hey, I was happy when Congress added a luxury tax on boats. Until I realized I make the boats.
Are you getting wiped out by Congress? Is their helpful hand the hand that's driving you to the poorhouse? Well, now you can protect yourself and your family. You have car insurance, you have home insurance, you have fire insurance. Now you can have Congress insurance. That's right, EIB Actuaries Incorporated can help you survive the helping hand of Congress. Here's all you do. Send us everything you make over $20,000 and we'll guarantee you and your family food, clothing, and shelter no matter what the goofy laws Congress passes. That's three meals a day and snacks. The next time you hear,
we only want to help you.
Pick up the phone and call 1-555-CONGRAB. Not available to federal employees. First, there was the Carter administration.
22% interest rates?
Double-digit inflation?
Now, Pinhead is back, and he's got his eye on the White House again. Bill Clinton in Tax Razor 2. He's a tax and spend Democrat dressed in sheep's clothing. But don't let his clever disguise fool you.
Invest in America.
He's got only one thing on his mind. Taking more of your money out of your pocket. Bill Clinton is Tax Razor 2. He's a master of waffling on issues and stretching the truth.
The draft board never called me. I never used my influence. Jennifer who?
Bill Clinton in Tax Razor 2. He and his wife Hillary have got a whole bag of tricks they want to try on you. Bill Clinton in Tax Razor 2. Elect to see this, and you'll be paying for it for the next 4 years. In a castle deep in the heart of Arxylvania, there lives an evil as old as the Democratic Party itself. Paramount Pictures presents Bill Clinton in Taxula.
Count Taxula, arise! It is I, your faithful servant, Al Gore. Your agenda requires that you feed.
Thank you, Al Gore. Have you raised the cafe standards?
Yes, master.
Slated my draft records?
Yes, master.
Good, good. Then I am off.
Happy hunting, master.
He lays in waiting until his hunger calls. Then he pounces on anyone who makes over $36,000 per year, sucking the lifeblood out of every American taxpayer.
Sir, we found his paycheck lying here, drained of every penny.
How could anyone do this in good conscience? It's inhuman.
All the while, using his charisma and slick character to hypnotize his victims.
Just look into your television. Invest in America. Invest in America. Invest!
Bill Clinton is Taxula. He sleeps in the daytime and has been known to prowl at night.
Oh, Willie, do that again.
Bill Clinton is Taxula.
Come on, Al Gore. Let's go to Congress. I'm hungry.
And there's more. We've only just begun.
Get ready, America, for a wild ride, because you're going to take a Clinton cruise.
Okay!
Yes, beginning January 20th, you can take a trip on Clinton Cruise Line straight into paradise. Because with Clinton, we make it seem like you haven't got a care in the world. At Clinton Cruise Lines, our crew of eight represents a cross-section of every American. And they're there to make sure you have the time of your life. Our doctor makes sure you stay healthy.
Gee, I don't know, Doc. This sounds like it could cost a lot.
Oh, don't worry. Just sign for it. The other passengers will end up paying for it anyway.
Our yeoman purser will make sure you have plenty of money.
I haven't had a job in years. Haven't tried to get one either.
Well, here's a check. Enjoy!
Our cruise director will make sure you have a great time.
Free condoms! Get your free condoms right here! Free condoms!
And our captain will oversee the entire trip.
Hi, I'm Captain Steve. Hurry and sign up. I'm thinking about re-enlisting in the Navy.
Oh, my! Oh.
Hop on the SS Frigidaire Queen today and take a 4-year trip on Clinton Cruise Lines. Clinton Cruise Lines, we're ready to take America for a ride. And now, another chill-packed episode of Taxula. When we last left Taxula, a gloomy black cloud hung over our nation's capital. And inside the formerly festive White House, Al Gore, Taxula's faithful companion, lurched painfully towards the Oval Office.
Enter! Ah, it is my faithful servant, Al Gore! What is wrong, Al Gore? You look upset. I know. Hillary's desk is bigger than yours. You're bored, Al Gore. Nothing to do? No diplomatic funerals to attend? No town meetings? No trees to hug? There must be something to keep you busy, Al Gore.
Oh, Willie!
It is the bride of Taxula. She is always bossing me around.
What was that, dear?
Oh, nothing, darling. What is it you want?
Is Al Gore in there?
Why, yes, he is.
Could you send him to get his key signed in a cabinet meeting and we're getting hungry.
Yes, dear.
And Willie.
Yes, Poopsie.
When he gets back, the car could use another coat of wax.
Will Al Gore ever find anything useful to do? Will the pizza arrive hot without the cheese stuck to the top of the box? Stay tuned for another thrilling episode of Taxula. First, there were gremlins. And now someone new is coming to town. Washingtonian Pictures presents Lefty. They appear cute and unassuming, but feed their power-hungry appetites, and they transform into little monsters. A university chancellor becomes a health and human services secretary. A corporate attorney becomes a maniacal commerce secretary.
Conflict of interest? What conflict of interest?
A former Carter administration official becomes attorney general.
Really? I didn't know they were illegal aliens.
And a wife and mother becomes first lady.
I'll have a say in everything.
Lefties will scare you to death as they ravage, terrorize, and devour everything in sight.
Eating more tax money.
And they're all led by the biggest lefty of them all.
Invest in America.
And his little toad, Al Gore.
Let's go to the Senate.
Lefties. No matter how much they beg, no matter how much they whine, never, ever feed their power-hungry appetites. Coming soon from Washingtonian Pictures. Another chill-packed episode of Taxula. When we last left Count Taxula and Al Gore was frustrated that all the work around the castle was being given to Hillary, the bride of Taxula. This week, the dastardly duo is busy in the laboratory of Count Taxula. Al Gore, I can barely contain myself. Months of building of sweat and labor are coming to a close.
You mean you finished painting Hillary's office, Master?
No, you idiot. My creation is almost finished.
Oh, yes, Master. You've created the perfect beast.
Together, Al Gore, you digging up the bodies of dead 60s activists and me piecing them all together. Now we are ready to give it life.
Yes, Master.
And now the finishing touch, the brain. The brain, Al Gore. You do have the brain.
Personally?
Never mind.
Oh, here it is, Master. Just as you requested.
Ah, thank goodness. The last thing we need around here is another Donna Shalera running around.
Good one, Master. Yes, Master. Here it is. The brain of Karl Marx. Just as you requested.
Now, Al Gore, we give it life. Turn on the transmogrifier. We must fill him with the lifeblood of Taxula. Tax money!
Yes.
It's alive, Al Gore!
Look!
My perfect beast stirs! Now, my beloved monster, rise! Rise! Al Gore, I give you Frankenreich!
Taxula's new monster, Frankenreich, terrorized the countryside to create his diabolical workers' paradise. Or will his plans come up a little short? Will Taxula have to build his new labor secretary a special Hervé Velasquez edition podium? Will Hillary's office ever get painted? Stay tuned to the next spine-chilling tax-raising episode of Taxula.
Not raise taxes on the middle class to pay for these programs. If the money does not come in there to pay for these programs, we will cut other government spending or we will slow down the phase in of the programs. I am not going to raise taxes on the middle class to pay for these programs. I will not raise taxes on the middle class to pay for these programs. I am not going to raise taxes on the middle class to pay for these programs. I will not raise taxes on the middle class to pay for these programs.
This is the Rush Limbaugh Program.
You're listening to the EIB Network. On January 20th, did President Bill Clinton declare war on productive Americans? How can you fight back? Send for the Clinton-era survival kit. Yours absolutely free from the American Spectator. Sealed in a confidential tamper-proof pouch, the Clinton-era survival kit provides exclusive reports on Bill, Hillary, and their plans to raise your taxes, radicalize the legal system, and indoctrinate your children. This is inside information the liberal news media wants suppressed at all cost. You get all this free, plus an up-close profile of the man most feared by the Clinton administration, Rush Limbaugh. Call 800-537-8500 to get your free, sealed, confidential Clinton-era survival kit, along with 12 issues of the American Spectator, the nation's most fearless magazine, for just $29.95. Remember, it's President Clinton now. He's fit, he's rested, and he's coming after your wallet. Call 800-537-8500 for your free Clinton-era survival kit. Call today. Call now. 800-537-8500 and ask for the American Spectator.
Scott Motor Company has been selling and servicing fine motor cars since 1922. And right now, they have the best selection of fine Cadillacs and Pontiacs that they have offered in many years. You can have the elegance of a 93 Cadillac or the excitement of a new Pontiac at a special deal now. Scott offers rebates up to $2,500 or 4.9% APR financing. Get all the details at Scott Motor Company on the Highway 70 bypass across from the Holiday Inn. While there, see the 93 all-new Fleetwood Cadillac rear-wheel drive. Learn about the safety of a Cadillac, the performance of a Cadillac, especially the North Star system, a motor so dependable that the first tune-up is recommended at 100,000 miles. In that large selection of motor vehicles, you'll see a large selection of minivans, too. In short, Scott Motor Company has the car or minivan that you're thinking about. Scott Motor Company on Highway 70 bypass, across from the Holiday Inn, Goldsboro.
Here we are at AIM Electronics, 411 East Ash Street, to tell you all about the inventory reduction sale on all JVC products in stock to gather, make room for the new spring models, so there's big savings to take advantage of. Installation available from AIM Electronics. All products backed by the service department. They care about what they sell. They care about satisfying customer needs. I want to try out this digital voice synthesizer here.
AIM Electronics, 411 East Ash Street, Goldsboro.
Ooh, I'll take one.
It's easy to find a good place to eat in Goldsboro. All you do is go to Madison's Prime Rib at Berkeley and Ash Street. Every night, Buddy Meyer's offering a 16-ounce, one-pound USDA choice T-bone with baked potato or stuffed potato and salad bar, just $7.99. And on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday nights, an 8-ounce, half-pound prime rib or ribeye with baked or stuffed potato and salad bar, $5.99. Great eating, a friendly atmosphere, Madison's Prime Rib, Berkeley Boulevard at Ash Street in Goldsboro.
Performing my job with flawless broadcast excellence, this is Rush Limbaugh on WGBR. Back at 1-800-282-2882 to Chicago we go. Greg, hi. Welcome to the Rush Limbaugh program.
Dittos, Russ from Chicago.
Thank you so much.
All kidding and politics aside, I have something very important for the future that Clinton is cutting. He speaks of investment in the future.
Mm-hmm.
What I'm speaking is of the advanced reactor development.
You know, that really is a good point, because he talked nuclear. This business of
investing in America's future, new technologies, targeting new industries. Man, this is the solution to so many problems these people claim to have, like filth, pollution, and all that.
Yeah, and I'll tell you what, the technology we're developing here recycles nuclear waste that is sitting in fuel pools and power plants all across the country.
What do you mean the technology we are? You mean where you work?
Yeah, I'm on my lunch hour right now, and glad I got to the phone because I got to go back to work here pretty quick. I'm just a lab technician here, and
what do you mean just a lab technician? Sounds pretty impressive.
Well,
how many people can be lab technicians?
Well, I'm one. I run the prototype of the IFR electrorefiner.
You run the prototype of the IFR electrorefiner?
Yeah, that's it.
Well, I'm impressed.
The integral fast reactor.
That's right. That's right. How many people could do this? I'm not being facetious. This is a new technology. This should be a targeted industry.
Yeah, actually,
this is something, let's make nuclear safe. Why can't that become a national, if we got a problem with it? And if we think it's too dangerous, let's make it safe.
It is safe. It's very much safer than the reactors they have now. We're talking going in online with this maybe 20, 50 years into the future. But if we stop now, I mean, where's that going to leave us?
Well, see, Bill Clinton has to defund this or not support this because this is a good lesson, folks. The left, the militant environmentalists, the anti-nuclear crowd are not into enhancing prosperity. They are not into improving lifestyles. They're into rolling them back. That's what they seek to do. That's what they consider to be pure and as a primary means of conservation. It's Greg, I'm glad you called. Thank you so much. We're behind you. We support you. And we always will. We'll be back in just a minute.
You're listening to the EIB Network.
It's timely. It's informative. It's interesting. It's educational. It's enlightening. It is educational. Did I say educational? I said it's educational. It's all of these things and more. What? Oh, pray, you ask. Do I refer to? I refer to the Conservative Chronicle. As you know, a charter advertiser of the Rush Limbaugh program. You are conservative. Even if you're not conservative, even if you're liberal and you want to know the heart of conservatism, that's the Conservative Chronicle, because every conservative newspaper columnist and thinker published in America today is published in compendium form every week in the Conservative Chronicle. This is it. This is the only source to find out what all of these brilliant thinkers think. Opinion based with fact is unstoppable when it comes from conservatives. The Conservative Chronicle is $39 a year for 52 issues every year. 800-888-3039 is the number. That's 1-800-888-3039. Call them now.
Places to go, people to see. Don't want to be tied down. I need to be free.
Last week, a guy called with a $1 million contract. I was out on a job, and if I didn't have my cellular phone, I would have lost the deal.
I need the freedom to roam. Just hand me my Centel cellular phone.
This guy had 300 head of cattle to sell. He was waiting for another buyer to get back to him, but I got on the horn to my client, closed the deal on the spot. Before I switched to Centel cellular, getting that call through could have been mighty tough.
My Centel cellular phone.
What makes a Centel cellular phone? Centel cellular service. It's the only way to get cellular freedom. Experience it yourself. Call 1-800-788-2260.
I need the freedom to roam. Just hand me my Centel cellular phone. My Centel cellular phone.
Horace Vick, owner of Monk's Furniture, talks about furniture shopping.
The real question is what they pay for what they get, not how much they get off. There's no free lunches out there, no freebies. Everything that you buy, you know, you got to pay for it.
Horace, what do you mean when you talk about shopping the warehouse way at Monk's?
Well, at Monk's shopping the warehouse way, what we do is we give you that sale price every day. Whenever you come into Monk's Furniture, you're going to get the lowest possible price that we can give on that merchandise. Our value is going to be there for you every day. So you don't have to be a real keen, sharp buyer. We're going to take care of that for you in the coming months furniture. We value our customers, and our job here is to give you the most furniture we can for the money. And Monk does that every day of the week. For the customer to get his satisfaction and satisfied with the style, the fabric, and the quality, and the price. And I think that is where the real value comes in.
Monk's Furniture, Highway 70 east of LaGrange at Little Baltimore. Big city selection, small town prices, hometown service.
We're the talk of the town, 1150 WGBR.